Hello and welcome you in the course of probability and statistics. Now I am your instructor Hardik Joshi. Now in this particular lecture we have to study the student key distribution and we have to see the example corresponding to the first application. So already we have to seen say one example, so these are the second example. Now the second example suggests that a sample of 10 students from a school was selected. So just remember this thing, the sample of 10 students, that is 10 students, so is our first observation. Their score in a particular subjects are 72, 82, 96, 85, 84, 75, 76, 93, 94 and 93, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So the question suggests that the sample of 10 students is collected and their score is given. Now can we support the claim that the class average score is 90? So we have to check this last statement, that is our claim, and we have to check the average score is 90 or not, is our job. So let's start the solution. So in right now we have to not explain the whole procedure, but I have give you the hint and we have to match with the procedure. So our first step, that is we have to define the hypothesis. So first of all we have to define the null hypothesis, that is H naught. So whatever given in the definition we have to assume it may be right. So question, that is definition, tells that the average score of the 10 student is 19. That means we have to assume that the average score, that is mean, is 90. That is mean is not significantly differ from 90. So same thing is reflect here, that is the class average score is not significantly differ from 90. Null hypothesis, always we have to assume that statement what is given in the question, that is definition. Now on the against, that is in the controversy of this null hypothesis, we have to define the alternative hypothesis, that is H1, that is mu is not equal to 19. So you have to easily identify the null hypothesis states that the average score is 90. So it may be possible, say it's against, that is it may be less than 90, it may be greater than 90. That's why we have to consider mu not equal to 90. That's why we have to select that two-sided alternative hypothesis, because we are interested either it may be less than 90 or it may be greater than 90. In both the case we have to say that is not equal to 90, that is the class mean score is significantly differ from 90. So step number 2, we have to gather the data. So the given sample information is given for the 10 students. So the number of observation, that is the size of the observation n, is equal to 10. And definitely remember the one thing, t statistic or t distribution is applicable whenever the size of the sample are small. And we know that when we have to say that is a small sample, when the number of observation is less than equal to 30. So here is 10, so we have to say is a small sample, then and only then t statistics is applicable, otherwise we have to go through the z statistics. Now at the beginning of the testing of hypothesis, definitely we have to define the level of significance. Now in this definition is not given, that's why we have to assume the level of significance is 5%. But remember, it's not rigid, you may be assume the level of significance is 1% also. Now the well-known level of significance is 1% or 5%. Now 10% or 20% we have to select if and only if it is defined in the definition, otherwise we have to not taken that. Now step number 4, corresponding to the data we have to identify the t statistics. So t statistics corresponding to this null hypothesis is x bar minus mu naught upon s upon square root of n, where x bar is the sample mean, mu naught is the population mean, S is the standard deviation and this N, that is the total number of observation. Now step number 5, we have to calculate this t statistics. So to calculate t statistics, that is ultimately we have to find out this sample mean. So here to calculate the sample mean, we have to write down the mark score by the 10 students in this particular first column, that is 72, 82, 96 and so on 93. That is the score covered by 10 students is already given in the definition. Remember, these are the one of the procedure to calculate the mean. Here we have to apply this mean, assume mean procedure, because we have to apply this assume mean procedure. So the corresponding data, that is numbering, is a very small number. So we have to assume that 85 is a sample mean. We have to assume capital A, that is assume mean is 85. And this particular column we have to find out xi, that is data minus assume mean, that is 85 minus 85, that is 0. 96 minus 85, that is 11. 82 minus 85, that is negative 3. Similarly, 93 minus 85, so 8. Finally, we have to find out sum of this particular column, so we have to get 0. Next, we have to find out this square of this particular column, that is 13 square, that is 169, 3 square 9, 0 square 0, and so on, 8 square is 64. Finally, find out the sum of this last column, that is sum of mu square, that is 690. Remember, these are the one of the procedure. This procedure is too much helpful when you have to appear for any of the competitive exam. The main purpose of this assume mean procedure, the digits becomes very small. Right now our goal is not that. So simply to calculate the mean of this data, we have to just find out addition, that is 72 plus 82 plus 96 plus 85 and so on 93. Whatever answer you have to get, divide by 10. So definitely it gives the mean. So as you wish, either you have to find out that method or go through this. Here just we have to highlight the one of the strategy to calculate the mean. So the sample mean, the assumed mean formula is, sample mean is equivalent to assumed mean plus sum of ui upon n. And assumed mean is 85, but sum of ui is 0, so it's lit 0, so 85. So we have to get the sample mean is 85. Remember, whatever 10 data is given, just you have to find out the addition of that data, 10 data divided by 10, then you have to get the same value 85. So it's not necessary, you have to strictly follow this procedure. Now finally, we have to find out the standard deviation by using this formula, sum of ui upon n minus 1, where n minus 1 is known as the degree of freedom. So sum of ui is already we have to calculate in our previous table, so it's 690. Now total number of observation is 10, so 10 minus 1 is 9. So by solving this, we have to get the standard deviation is 8.756. So finally, we have to calculate the t statistics, x bar minus mu naught upon standard deviation upon square root of n. So sample mean, that is 85. Now population mean is defined in the definition, that is given in the question, is 90. Standard deviation is 8.756. The total number of observation is 10. So we have to get negative 5 upon 2.77. So by solving that, we have to get negative of 1.806. Finally, we have to take on the modulus, so we have to get the positive value 1.806. So we have to obtain the observed t value. Now step number 6, whatever we have to obtain observed t value, yeah, calculated t value, now we have to compare with the experimental yet tabulated t value. So remember, our alternative hypothesis we have to select is a two-sided alternative hypothesis. Now level of significance is 5. So and the total number of observation, that is 10 students, we have to collect the score of 10 students, that is n is 10. So degree of freedom is n minus 1, that is 10 minus 1 is 9. Level of significance alpha is 5%, but is a two-sided test, that is 0.05 divided by 2, so we have to obtain 0.025. So we have to take on this tabulated t value from the t distribution table, and we have to get is 2.262. So next I will show you how we can collect this tabulated t value from the t distribution table. Now for that you have to remember the three things. First one is two-sided is the alternative test, level of significance is 9 and level of significance is 5%. So see here is a two-sided test, 5% level of significance and degree of freedom is 9. So corresponding t value is 2.262. So finally, in step number 7, we have to give our decision whether the null hypothesis is reject or not reject on the basis of this modulus t naught is less than t experimental or not. So the observed t value. So observed t value we have to calculate obtain is 1.806 and experimental, that is tabulated t value, is 2.262. That is 1.8 is less than 2.26. So it indicates that the given sample does not provide sufficient evidence to reject the null hypothesis. Hence we conclude that the average score of the 10 students is 90. So finally, again we have to repeat that it indicates that the given sample does not provide sufficient evidence to reject H naught. That is, alternatively we have to say that our null hypothesis is accepted. So thank you so much for paying your attention.